If you had asked me when I was in college, would I ever picture myself being a deaf individual listening to surgeon put in a cochlear implant with the drill in their hand, that I would be able to hear them talking, I would never have believed you.
Hey Internet, Harris here. So a couple months ago, Cochlear reached out to me asking if I wanted to take a look at the cochlear implant technology. How it works, what it does, what it can do, and how it operates. In this video, we're going to take a look at how cochlear implant recipients are able to take back their hearing and, using Cochlear's innovative technology, get back the sounds they love. Cochlear actually worked with Apple to create the first and only MFI, or made for iPhone, cochlear implant sound processor. The Nucleus 7 sound processor works with your smartphone through the Nucleus Smart App to allow users to use technology to better connect to their world. In high school psychology, I learned about cochlear implants and I knew they were very powerful, but to actually see how they work and exactly what they do was something even cooler. Let's go ahead and check this out.
My name is Mark Campbell Foster. I've been with Cochlear for 8 years now as an audiologist with the company. I am a bilateral cochlear implant recipient. And I've been implanted in my first side for 15 years now, and on my second side for 8 years now. So I received my first hearing aid just before I was age 5, and then my hearing just got worse and worse over time until I was a junior in college. And I met an audiologist that said to me, hearing aids are at the max, so if you wanna consider hearing better, consider a cochlear implant. And I just remember being a junior in college thinking, you know, I've grown up with hearing aids and I've grown up in a world where I'm surrounded by hearing people. So, and now I have to decide the rest of my life in terms of what am I going to do for work and things like that, and what community do I want to be in. So that really gave me the push to look into cochlear implants. And for those of you watching who don't know what a cochlear implant is, or what it does treat, is that it treats hearing loss. And with the ear, we have three parts. Obviously, we have the outer ear, and then the second most talked about one is probably like all when you hear about ear infection, in the middle ear space. But behind that is what's known as the cochlea, and everybody thinks about the snail-shaped seashell they see on the beach. That's the part where I have my hearing loss, so that's known as the inner ear. And when hearing aids don't work to give you clarity to understand words anymore, you may be a candidate for a cochlear implant. And so this little dummy that I'm holding is actually what the cochlear implant is. And this tiny, tiny little piece is actually what goes inside the cochlea that stimulates my cochlea, doing the job that my hearing, my own natural ears can't do. And so this little guy right here is what helps me hear myself talking right now. This is actually tucked underneath my skin. This is actually a demo of it. You really can see the slight side profile right here. And so I love this ear model because it dispels the myth that it's a brain surgery, because it's absolutely nowhere near the brain. And we're actually going right into here. This is the guy that makes the magic too. So as you can see, it magnetically sticks on. So like a hearing aid, there is a piece that can sit on the ear and it picks up the sound. And cochlear implants always make the assumption that you're looking at what you want to hear. And these microphones pick up the sound and then encodes it to a digital code. And the external part talks to the inside part by radio frequency waves. So I like to think of it as like a radio station where you're tuning information and sending it across the skin. And so that information then goes to what's called the receiver stimulator, which is this square-shaped object right here. So fundamentally, though, that is ultimately how a cochlear implant works, is that sound gets picked up, it gets sent to the internal, which stimulates the cochlea, which is connected to the auditory nerve, which sends the information to the brain.
So Mark just provided some great background on how cochlear implant technology works. Next, we'll look at how the Nucleus 7 sound processor allows cochlear implant users to customize their sound and their hearing to their life and their needs.
I always think about, well, how much better can I do? And the being able to just directly connect to my iPhone, so if my phone were to ring right now, I would automatically just get this crystal clear clarity right to my ears. So think about when you guys pick up your phone, you are picking it up to your ear, but you're still hearing all the environmental sound. When I do that, I can hear all the environmental sound as well, or I can then narrow how much I hear just to the phone, giving me such crystal clarity. I'll have like my phone on the counter in the kitchen or in my pocket as I'm walking around, and I'm truly like hands-free. You know, we have something called a phone clip. And the phone clip was pretty cool because it allowed you to connect to your phone before we had made for iPhone connectivity. But it is something that you have to wear and keep charge. I now have a technology built into something that I carry, just like my wallet. It's phenomenal. And I use this like all the time. So I'm streaming Waves. I'm listening to my son in the back seat. You know, with the mini microphone. So this is what's known as a remote mic or a mini mic, and I can then put this on someone not sitting nearby me or across a table or to someone giving a lecture, and they'll stream direct to my ear. So now when my sister sends a video of my nephew, the niece and nephews, I get that audio played right to my ear. I can do FaceTime now, looking at and be able to speech read and lip read what's being said and get all those cues, and I can be anywhere. So the other thing that I really like about live listens, sorry, I'm entering my passcode, is the fact that I can just simply go into my phone settings, and this is the native setting from Apple. Say I'm having a difficult time hearing you, Harris, across the room. I can turn my phone on into a live listen mode. I just got the trill, so I have my phone across the table, and this will act like a remote mic. So I'm just gonna turn this off because I'm just hearing myself even louder. But right there, I'm able to give myself instant access to hearing in a portable way so that I'm never without, because if I have to have the mini mic all the time, which is great, because I do, this is actually what I use in the OR. I have my surgeon wear the mini mic underneath their gown, and I'm able to hear as if I'm standing right in the sterile field, even though I'm across the room. But I have that ability right on my phone. So say I find myself in an unexpected situation where I need a mini mic and I don't have it, I know I always have my phone, can I never leave home without it. But Cochlear also has their own app. It's called the Nucleus Smart App. And so this is, so you can tell like right away, I know that my volume a little bit different. I'm volume 10 on my left side and volume 9 on my right. That's just how it balances out to me, but I can visually see that. And that's really what has been so great about this, is that it can be as complex or as simple as you want it to be. Like right now, I just looking at it, I know my setting. But if I click right here, I can just do a complete troubleshoot of my entire system. So I can tell that my left battery is about 75%, but I've got full charge on my right. I can see that my mic protectors are nice and clear, because I can see that speech is coming into the realm of where we want it to be, so that it's still audible to me. It also has other cool features where you can track the type of speech that you're in. So it actually tracks how much time I'm hearing speech, so that if you go to your audiologist and say, you know what, I don't feel like I'm hearing as well as I could, we could go into my phone and actually discuss, well, you're actually not getting a lot of exposure to speech, so what can we do to get you more active? Do you live alone? Do you listen to books on tape? And things like that. In closing, getting a cochlear implant, first and foremost, has really widened the entire aspect of my life. I really truly feel cochlear implants have given me limitless opportunities. I can pretty much, with all the confidence it has given me, I feel I can handle pretty much any situation. And the fact that now I feel like cochlear implant technology and cochlear is really on the forefront of this cutting edge technology, because to be able to eliminate the need of a remote control and have everything on an app, we still have our remote controls, but to have everything on an app and to be able to stream everything, because everything pretty much comes into me on my phone, and to be able to have instant access and instant hearing and the best hearing possible has truly been revolutionary for me.
Cochlear helps people connect better to the world using technology that we use every day, primarily through our smartphones, combined with their sound processors, allows for a lot of really life-changing things to happen. If you or somebody that you know might be interested in this technology or any of the offerings, I will leave links in the description to check out for further information. Anyway, thank you for watching.